Consumer Federation of America did a study that found that poor individuals actually end up paying more for their auto insurance. Now, they compared people who have a clean record, but they come from low-income households, to people who actually make more money, but they have points on their records. And they found that, yeah, it turns out poor people do pay more for their premiums.
Man, that's so depressing.
So
we can't catch a break, man. The rest of the country cannot catch a break. Because in this case, if you said, hey, listen, poor people are more likely, because of actuarial reasons, we did the calculations, they're more likely to get into accidents. That sucks. And I don't know if you should take that into account. Anyway, of course, there are legitimate things you can take into account, whether it's a younger driver and other demographic things. We get that, right? But obviously, you also know that you can't take into account their race as an example, right? Mm-hmm. Let's say for some reason, pick a random race, Asians. Got into more car accidents. Red. Okay. You couldn't say, hey, you're Asian, I'm charging you more, right? So there is certain laws that we can pass on this. But in this case, they're not even getting into more accidents.
No, but here's the really, really interesting thing, okay? Obviously, in the U.S., you cannot charge someone more for auto insurance just based on their income, right? But what they do is they look at occupation, they look at the location of the residence, and they also look at credit history. Okay, and then they judge the premiums based on that.
But I didn't look at your income. What do you mean? I gave the doctor a lower, insurance. Just golly gee, just kind of worked out that way.
Right.
And by the way, looking at your zip code, it doesn't take a genius to figure out which zip codes are going to get charged more and which are going to get charged less.
But if you look at the driving trends of wealthy individuals as opposed to poor individuals, people who are poor are actually less likely. They drive half as much, according to studies, compared to wealthy individuals. And the reason why that happens is because gas, maintenance, all of that is expensive. So they will only drive if they're going to and from work. Of course, there are some exceptions and all that. But I guess what happens with the auto insurance companies is they'll look at where the individual is living and they'll say, well, they're more likely to have their car stolen and they're more of a risk, this and that. But that's actually not true.
Mm-hmm. And because in this case, as we just showed you, they have more points on their record,
right,
for the higher income, and they get charged less. Man, it gets frustrating. It seems like we just cannot catch a break, right, in this country. By the way, it's true in so many different instances. You go to buy a house, they charge you a higher interest rate if you're poorer than if you're richer. You know? So, yes, you can make it out of all of that, right? And I do really believe that, and I know sometimes liberals get at me and they say, oh, it's a fake dream and it's a nightmare and it's American dream is not true. Yes. No, you can work past it. It is possible. But they don't make it easy on you, okay? And the Republicans that go around like Herman Cain, like, oh, what? What's the big deal? Yeah, just work a little bit, and pleasure a couple of the rich white guys like I did, and then you get rich. What's the big deal, right? And no, it's really freaking hard. And anybody trying to make it up, they're constantly putting you down and charging you more, etc.